Okay, we're Josie Nugent and Brian Stafford. We've just released an album, The Caves of Kong, and I'm from Derry originally. Josie's from here in Ennis, well, just outside. And what else can we say about ourselves that makes sense?
Don't say anything else. I'll ask all those pertinent questions.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Now, what are you going to play?
We're going to play a couple of jigs from the album. The first one's called My Enforcer, and the second one's called Kiss the Widow. And they both come from the Goodman collection, the first volume of the Tunes of the Munster Pipers. So they're local tunes from pre-famine periods.
Okay. Shoot away.
Right.
It's so seamless, you know. It seems you've been playing together all your lives. So what's the connection between the two of you apart from musically? I heard something happened in the Isle of Skye recently.
Well, we just got married, that's why.
Congratulations. And how long have you been playing together? Because it is seamless playing.
It's about getting on 2 years, yeah. I think.
2 years.
We met, I think, before the All Ireland Flan Derry.
Yeah.
We met actually
the mayoral reception. For the Flat Committee when they were visiting Derry, so that would have been, about 2 years ago now.
And you swept Josie off her feet with your pipe playing, was it?
Well, she's been coming to terms with pipes ever since.
learnt a lot about piping in the last 2 years.
All right, okay. No, it's beautiful. It's, as I said, it's so seamless, as if you've been playing together all your lives. Josie, you've had an album out in 2010 with your sister Mary, and that was the last of your recordings, was it?
That would be the last, yeah, Hills and Hollows.
Okay.
We have been in here with it as well, yeah, and that was with my sister. So I really, you know, enjoyed coming back to my Clare roots for that album.
Right.
And this one's been quite a different journey because we've taken tunes from the collections, and we've enjoyed going through the collections like Petrie, Roche, Goodman.
And there's one
more recent
couple
one
of
then.
Tunes from Nigel Bullier, who's a friend of ours living in Bangor. He's recently published a collection on a social history in a book called Handed Down. So that was interesting as well.
Right. And you're from Derry originally.
Yes.
And what's the history of piping, Illan piping in Derry?
Well, in the, I suppose around about the 70s, there was a pipe maker there, Finbar McLaughlin, who in fact was one of the founder members of the Pibury Illan. And Finbar started making pipes and teaching in the city around about that time. He made this set, this is one of his earlier sets, and he also taught me to play, and I would have started playing round about the same time as Joe McHugh, Joe McLaughlin, and John McCarran came along a wee bit later, so we've all dispersed since, but there was a good healthy piping scene in the city at the time.
And all down to?
All down to one man, yeah, Finbar.
Amazing, isn't it? And where do you live now? You don't live in Derry?
No, we live in Belfast now.
And that's pretty vibrant musically, isn't it?
There's lots of music there, loads of sessions going on.
Yeah.
You know, there's Donal O'Connor, the McSherry's, and then as well as that, we go up to Bangor.
Yeah. All right.
Brendan O'Hare.
Brendan O'Hare runs
Shane McAleer.
Oh, yeah, nice Shane. Yeah, Shane's a lovely fiddle player.
So, yeah.
Then you have Nigel, whom we spoke about earlier, plays in Bangor.
And what does he play instrument?
He plays banjo and fiddle.
Oh, lovely. Okay. And when was this thought out, or when did you decide to the Caves of Cong? When did it see the light of day, or why?
Oh, that's been our project since about November last year. I had originally had at the back of my mind that I would do a solo album based on the Goodman stuff, and then we started getting more into the other collections, and I think, to be fair, it became a big enough of a project that it seemed to be a more natural fit as a duo. So most of the material on it, we basically got together since about November last year.
All right.
Put a wee bit of thought into how do we structure it, how do we make it.
So we create our own journey with it.
Yeah.
Just trying to, it was our own production.
Sure. And where did you record it?
In Dublin.
With John Blake in Dublin.
Oh, John in Dublin. Lovely.
So I think John records everybody these
days. He's pretty prolific as a player and as a producer and, recording.
He's a dead easy guy to work with, and I would recommend anyone to go to him if they need an album done, because
All right.
He's an absolute breeze.
And apart from him recording it, would he have had input into the production of it, or deciding what tunes are good, or that was all ye?
That was entirely us. Yeah.
All right.
We had pretty much
we've done our homework.
Yeah.
Before we went into the studio.
Oh, I see.
And I think Barch Engine, one track.
Yeah. And are you like any other musicians who produce their own? You're so critical. Well, at least it came out, you know.
It's terrible listening to yourself, but I haven't met a person who doesn't think that.
Sure. Okay. No. It's good to see it, and you know, it's great to have it out, especially with Willie Clancy on 2014 on now. So I'm thrilled to have you, and thanks a lot for coming here.
No problem. Thank you. Thanks for having us.